In this video, we're going to learn how to create a crossword puzzle using Microsoft Excel. So this crossword puzzle is obviously going to be one that you can either email to your friends, and if they have Microsoft Excel, they can fill it out on their computer, or one that you can have it formatted so you can print it out in paper, and whether you're at a party or if you just want to keep the kids busy or whatever event, you can fill it out with pen or pencil. So to get started, the first thing I want to do is I want to go to the page layout tab. So I'm in the home tab. Now, I'm moving over to the page layout, and here under page setup, we're going to set our margins. I'm clicking on margin, and I'm going to choose the 1-inch margin with the 1/2-inch header footer. The reason for that is if you want to print this later and say you want to save it as a PDF file, those are going to be the default margin settings when you save your Excel document as a PDF. So we do that, and when we do that, you see here these very light dotted lines show up. So those let you know where your margins are. And as we scroll down, you see that those same margins show up here at the bottom. So we have our space. So the next thing we want to do is format so that our cells look like squares. So I've highlighted all of the cells, and you just click up here or do Control A, and that'll highlight all of your cells. And when you do that, you can put your cursor anywhere between the columns. So like, for example, I'm here between E and F, and you see those two little arrows side to side that are pointing. So you can drag to the right, they're bigger. You can drag to the left, it makes your cell width smaller. So this is probably a good cell width right here that we've chosen. And then we can do the same by going to the left-hand side where the numbered rows are. And same thing, you can put your cursor in any of them and the little arrows show up again where now they're pointing up and down. And we can drag down to make, let me highlight all again. We can drag down to make them bigger. We can drag up to make them smaller. But we want to have something that kind of resembles a square. So that looks more square-like. So now that we've done that, the next thing we want to do is to create our shaded area for the crossword puzzle. So I'm just scrolling over. I am highlighting to where margin line is, that dotted margin. And then I'm going to scroll down to the bottom where the bottom margin is, or that dotted line is. But then I'm going to scroll up and leave some space at the bottom. And for that is, that's where we're going to write our clues later. So we have this area chosen and everything is highlighted. I'm going to go back to the home tab. And here, first thing I want to do is I want to create my border. So I'm going to do just all borders. And then I'm going to go to the fill, the little paint can. That's your fill color. And in this case, I'm going to choose black just because that's the color of our borders. And that way we won't really see them. So the next thing I want to do, scroll right one more time to that big A, and that's your font color. So I want to choose white for this. This way I can see what it is that I'm typing. In this particular crossword, we're just going to have a random theme, and I'm going to use a vacation theme. To create the word, so we have here vacation, think of a word within your theme that's fairly long, but will still fit in your crossword. Once you have that word, you want to type it anywhere in the middle area of your crossword. So in this case, I'm going to just right here, column F, it's kind of in the middle from left to right. And I'm going to choose the word vacation because that's pretty long. So I'm going to type one letter in each cell. I'm using all caps, but you don't have to. Obviously, you can do them lowercase, just all caps is sometimes easier to read. So now that we have vacation and it's in the middle, this gives us space around the word to be able to create words to the side. So let's say I want to come down here and create suntan. So if you're going to a beach, this is a great theme to do. So we have suntan, and let's say up here we want to do coast. And you can keep going with words as you have those. But for just to illustrate for you how this can be done, we'll stop there. So the next thing we want to do is now we want to unhighlight where our words are. So now we highlight each word. We go back to our fill color. And this time we're going to choose no fill. Now you can choose white. The reason I like the no fill is, let's say you do print this out and you're printing on beige colored paper. You know, you're not going to end up with white boxes on beige color paper. So, you know, do as you wish, but I'm going to choose the no fill for that reason. You see that our letters disappear, but we're going to bring them back in just a minute. I'm just going to highlight these and get rid of the fill in those so they're no longer black fill. So now that we've done that, we're going to highlight everything again. It's just easier that way. Choose your color. I'm going to choose black for the letters, but you can choose obviously whatever color you want for your theme. So when we do that, all of our letters come back. So something else we want to do, and this will be important if you want to send this out electronically. We're going to highlight the area again where our words are, the crossword puzzle area, and we're going to come up here to alignment. Let's scroll back up. You can see what I'm doing. This lets you align vertically. So now it's centered up and down, or align horizontally that it's centered left to right. And when we do that, it moves each letter right to the middle of each cell. So the next thing we want to do is we want to create numbers, right? Because when we put in the clues, we'll want to number these. So this can be one, vacation will be clue number one, coast will be two, and this will be your third answer. So we just have those three for this example. So we're going to go over from the home tab and go to the insert tab. We click on that, and then we come over to text, and we want to insert a text box. So we'll just draw one just out here anywhere to the side. We'll draw a little one. In that text box, we'll just type in number one. We drag this text box over, and we place it here. And so that looks a little weird, right? Because it's overlapping on the black background. So then we just format the text box, right click, and we want to bring our fill to no fill. And we want to get rid of the outline, so we don't want an outline. Then now we just have this one that's floating here. So you just place it wherever you want, ideally in the top left of each, the first letter of each answer. So do that for the rest of them. So all I did here was just highlighted it and Control C to copy. And then I'm going to paste. And then I'm going to change that to two. And I'm going to paste. Copy that. And then my other version will do a three. And then we simply just drag it over. So coast will be two. And this will be three. And then down here, you just come to the very bottom of it and you can type in what you want your clues to be. So one can be was vacation. So this can be activity where we all relax and have fun. And then two is what was number two was coast, and say borders the ocean. And three, what happens when you lay in the sun? And you can keep doing that with whatever, however many words you have. And then ideally, you'll want to make a copy of this. So you'll do, you can come down here to the tab, right click, just move or copy, create copy. And this will be your original. And then you go back to, we'll call this game. And then you simply go back on your board, highlight everything, and delete. Now you have a blank game that you can share with other people, or you have your, you know, and you have your original, so you don't forget what the answers are if you need to go back to them. If you want to go ahead and print this, you can also go back to your page layout. You can do some print titles. We chose print titles and then header footer. You can go to header, and let's say in the middle section, we want to say our vacation be our header. Remember, we left that half inch margin for the header footer, so we have a little bit of space to play with. And we'll make the font a little bit bigger. We'll say 22 point font, italic. See how it changed a little bit here. So now we'll go into print preview, and this is what our puzzle, our crossword puzzle looks like. So hope you enjoyed making this crossword puzzle with me, and hope you have a lot of fun. And if you did like this, please make sure to give it a like. And make sure to subscribe to this channel so you're first one to receive new videos as they come out. Thanks.